Your privacy is respected here. It's just me for our on-demand library. I try to keep it updated. Probably had a pop-up there on your screen. Just close that, letting you know I'm recording class. All right, we are doing Twisted Tabata Timing. For the 20 seconds, I want you to actually rest today. And that can be easy movement, or it can be just standing still and taking nice deep breaths. The reason is I want you using everything you have for the 40 second intervals. So the heaviest weights you can safely lift, working as hard as you can. You know, depending on where you're at today, and every day is not the same, right? It is time. We're gonna get going with our warm up here. I just want our timer ready. I'll start warming up. All right, here we go. The step touch. I'll turn the music up. Just keep going. There we go. Knee pulls are coming up in 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms up, pull and march. You can always move at your own pace. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, jumping jacks. Music will come back. Hey, yo, big wave. Turn the mic on. Small time alongside JW. Keep going. You can do no jump jacks if jumping's not your thing. Nice cool breeze and big palm trees. I tell you, life 2, 1. Squat, arm circle. My bestie and your bestie dancing by the fire. Your bestie says you want parties, so can we make this? Hold this next one down and pulse. 3, 2, step out to the right. Center, left. Almost there. We're gonna hold this one over to the left. Drop that right shoulder, gentle twist. Grab your shoes, name it 2x2, and now we shine it bright. Shoulders to center. Shift that lunge over nice and low to the right. Drop the left shoulder, gentle twist. Shoulders to center. Shift your whole body to center. Half fold here. Bend those knees, heels go in. Take a deeper bend in the knees. Pat your tailbone round up nice and slow. Fingertips to the shoulders. Making circles backwards with those elbows. Take those arms out. Little circles, little quick circles. Make them bigger. And even bigger. So you're at your biggest range of motion. 4, 3, switch directions, big circles. Smaller. And even smallest and quickest. Ooh, should be starting to get a little warm. Fingers to shoulders, circle to the front. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Grab one or two weights, your choice. All right, we start with a power move. Every round starts with a power move. And then we have a right side, a left side, and a both sides, okay? So our power move, we're gonna hold our weights like we're goblet squatting. We're gonna hop or step to a goblet squat. Hop it up, goblet squat jack. Power move. If that is not for you, if you're not jumping today, step right, step left. Center your weight every time you squat. Lean to the side that led. Move number 2 is a staggered stance deadlift, right, then left, and both. And then we repeat. We use the 20 seconds to rest. I want you using everything you've got, whatever that means in tonight's moment, okay? Beast mode or not, everything you have tonight. Here we go. Whew. We got this. We have our goblet squat jacks. 3, 2, 1, 40 seconds. In our squats, check your form. That booty has to shift back. My hips are not in alignment with my knees. Knees are opening up over the second and third toe. Spine stays long. You hinge forward from the hips, maintaining weight in the heels for the squat. Whew. We have 10 seconds. We're resting in 3, 2, 1. Take your break. Let that heart rate recover. We start staggered stance. Booty pokes back. Weight stay close to the leg. We start in 8 seconds. Deep breath. Here we go. Heaviest weights we can manage. 3, 2, 1. Poke the booty back. Keep the weight in the front heel. Try to keep those hips square. We're at the halfway mark. Long spine, don't let those turtle shells come out. Again, weight is primarily in that front foot. We have 5 seconds. Trying to keep those hips square. 3, 2, 1, take some deep breaths. If you're new, I don't usually give you this much rest. That means I want you working really hard. Welcome, Deanna, Jane, Debbie, Janet, Christiana. All right, 5 seconds. Same move, other side. Soft bend in that knee. Extend. Right leg, let's start. Booty goes back. Push the mass of the earth away. Every time you stand up, think about really working the back side of that leg. Hamstring, glutes, with a nice strong squeeze at the very, very top. Push and squeeze. Beating with the heart. Folding from the hip, not the spine. Keep going. We've got Erin here, Andy, Terry, Valerie, Audrey, Brittany, Dan, Jeannie. Whew. 3 seconds. 2, 1. We're doing both legs. And then after we do both legs, we're going back to our goblet squat jack. And then we'll repeat one more time through. So for both legs, find somewhere between your hips to shoulders. We're gonna do the same thing. Booty goes back, knees bend, and let's start right now. Here we go. 40 seconds are on. Push through the heels. Push the mass of the earth away. We've got about 15 or so seconds here. Again, no turtle shells. Keep the weight in the heels. Move at a pace that challenges you. Three, two, and release. Back to goblet squat jacks or goblet step out alternating squats. All right, bring those weights to your heart center. Here we go. 3, 2. This is the last time we have to do this move. Let's go. 40 seconds. Remember, you can just step and alternate. You don't have to hop. Beautiful. Awesome, Debbie. Brittany is here. That's nice, Terry. Yeah, Jeannie. Halfway. These will sneak up on you tomorrow. I'm holding on your rope, got me 10 feet off the ground. Almost there, don't give up yet. 3, 2, One, now rest. Right leg. The leg. Staggered stance, deadlift. Push the mass of the earth away as you hinge on up. Set it up, here we go. Three, two, let's go. Push through the heel. You did full body blast with me. Backside of your legs might already be a little bit grouchy. 3 seconds. No round backs. Booty back, tail feathers back. Yes. 3, 2. Now take your break. Deep breaths. Finish strong. 2 more intervals. That's it. Let's get ready. We're starting in about 5 seconds. Left leg in front, right leg kickstands. Soft bend in that knee. 3, 2, go. Leading with the heart. Keeping the hips square. And what I mean by square hips, keep moving while I talk. If I had headlights right on the top of each iliac crest, when they're square, they're pointing straight ahead or straight down or straight up, right? If I open up my hips, one's pointing down, but the other one's kind of pointing out to the diagonal. We want to keep those hips square to the mat. We've got about 8 more seconds. 3, 2, 1 more. Now take your break. Both legs, heaviest weights you can manage. We're getting a little bit of a longer break in between. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Both legs, deadlift. Let's go. Really focusing on the back side of our legs for our lower body today. Last week, we kind of did a big focus on core. Breathe. We have 10 seconds, and then we are switching gears to upper body. We'll get a break in between. 3, 2, 1. All right, friends, you've got about 40, 50 seconds or so here. Our next set of moves, again, starting with a power move. We're gonna start with 2 weights and then you can set one down. We do a VFit maker. Bicep curl, palms to shoulders. Overhead press, palms away. Back to the biceps, so kind of like an Arnold press. Then we're gonna release, you squat. Step or hop to plank. Knees or toes, 1 row each side and a push up. And then we start over, there we are. Squat, curl, press. And so forth. If that's not for you, you skip the ground. Curl, press on, curl, booty back, row, row, row. That's your no ground V-fit maker. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. 40 seconds. Let's go. Remember, you can drop to those knees or toes. You don't have to get on the ground at all. If you are getting down into your plank, make sure those hands are right under the shoulders. Remember, we can just keep it right here. Row, row, and then you come right back into it. Yes. You don't have to get up and down. We have 3, 2, and 1, if you are on the mat, you have about 15 seconds to come up. Ditch one of your weights. I still have a workout here tonight. I'm gonna go light just for the sake of saving my strength. I want you to use something that challenges you. We have halos. Start in 3, 2, 1. Now, what I want you to do is to transfer that weight over to that right leg. And when you're ready, pick up the left. It could be a toe stand, right? And if you're being challenged along with your shoulders, take that halo as far around and down when you're in the back position as you can. 40 seconds is a long time here, so we're gonna break the other side up with a different move. We're gonna grab our two heavier weights. 3, 2, 1. Grab your second weight. We have regular old bicep curls to give our, that's a lot on the shoulders. Our shoulders are the most unstable joint in the body, so we wanna be kind. Here we go, biceps in 3, 2, 1. So just that first part of the VFit Maker, just curl. And I'm still using light weights. I have a workout later. And I need not fall on my head, so I'm gonna keep a little bit of strength in my arms tonight. Nice, Valerie. Yes, Suzanne. Nice, my friend Andy. Yeah, Aaron. Looking good, Audrey. Beautiful, Valerie, Terry. Rich, Cassiana, Janet. Oh, Kelsey made it. Deep. All right. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Set the weights down. We're going to halos next. So grab whichever weight you use for that. So we can get started with our weight center and then transfer in just a moment. We have 5, 4, 3, 2. Lift that weight up and start your halo. Really working that range of motion, and then when you're ready, start transferring that weight over and you can bring it into that balance. Next time through, we're gonna try to start in the balance and keep it there for the whole 40 seconds. I love to throw balance challenges in because these are the kind of drills that help us in real life. Trip on an uneven sidewalk, your core is ready to respond. You're less likely to fall, right? We have 4, 3, 2, 1. Really. All right, VFit Makers. Starting in about 12 seconds, deep breath. Everything you've got, you don't have to move again. Remember, you can get down to plank. You don't have to get all the way down to plank. You start in 3, 2, 1. Let's go, curl. Press, uncurl, right, then row, and then push up or double row. Yes. Almost there, 5 more seconds. Don't give up on me. You can slow down, just don't quit. 3, 2. All right, let's leave our one weight. We've got about 15 seconds. We're balancing the whole 40 seconds this time, right side. Here we go, set it up. 3, 2, weight up, 1, let's go. Nice, team. Pull that navel into the belly button. Remember, touching that toe down doesn't mean you're not balancing. Honor what your body needs from that time from day to day, right? Hour to hour. If your shoulders are getting tired, you can always switch or dip the weight. We have 4, 3, 2, 1. Bicep curls are next. Grab the weights you want for those. Starting in about 12 seconds, deep breath. Woo, athletic stance. Spread those toes wide, lift your arches, lift the kneecaps, squeeze the quads, squeeze the booties, but let's work the arms starting right now. Keeping that lower body engaged. If you're working really heavy weight and you're feeling like maybe I want to switch to a lighter weight, that's okay. But you can also go one at a time. That gives yourself a little bit more rest in between each rep. Still bracing ourselves through our midsection, shoulders down away from the ears. Think about those shoulder blades sliding down and together on either side of your spine. Whew. 5 seconds. And then we get our break and then our next round of halos. 3, 2, 1. Set one weight aside. Start in about 8 seconds. Balancing on the other side, the final side that you need to keep the feet in. For me, that's my left. To start, lift that foot. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Again, you can have that down. I just want most of your weight in one leg. We're just getting our core warmed up for our final round. It is on the mat. If the mat's not for you tonight, that's okay. You know, I gotcha. I have your modifications for you. Always. The shoulders are on fire. 4, 3, 2, and 1. If you're going to the mat, bring some weight with you. And it doesn't really matter how heavy they are. We're just gonna use them to keep our wrists neutral. So you can set those somewhere out of the way. All right, standing friends. For our first move, if you are standing, we're taking hands behind the head, squat, and then you're gonna come up and twist, squat, and twist. This is your power move, so I want you to really take it as low as you can, and powering up, twisting from the midsection, not flapping the wings, so twist. So if you're on your feet, that's move number one. Move number two, if you're on your feet, is a standing bird dog. You're gonna take your right foot down, left leg back, right arm up, knee to elbow. That's your move number two. My core is what I want working here. So contract, we can round the spine, squeeze the abs, and then work that balance. Heel to the diagonal, fingers to the diagonal. And then you'll take it to the other side when we come back. And your final move, if you're on your feet, our mummy kicks, straight legs, heart lifts, no jackknifing the body. I want you thinking about this part of your body lifting that straight leg up. You can practice and feel those low abs engage as you do that. So that's your final move. And then we'll do the other side of your bird dog when we come back to what we're doing on the floor. All right, if you're on the floor, real quick, I'm demoing and then we're getting right into it for time's sake. We're doing a beast squat to a groiner or a frogger. So your beast squat, we're gonna start in a plank, knees or toes. We're gonna squat back almost into a happy baby, but we're keeping our knees off the floor. And then you're gonna bound forward into your groiner. All the way to that stretch in the shoulders. If you want more, you're gonna jump. Plank, squat, jump. Plank, squat, jump. All right, here we go. Let's get started. Your choice, squat twisted leg or beast squat groiner, or just beast squat plank if that's what you're feeling. Go for it. If you're doing that jump with both legs, make sure you're hitting a plank before your beast squat. We're gonna get a lot of quads in there. Yes, and if you're up on your feet, you're doing your squat twist. Get that core, yes, beautiful. Here we go, 3, 2, One, take your break. If you're on your feet, this is your standing bird dog. If you're with me on the mat, we're doing single leg dog, the three leg plank, or three legged dog, the plank with that knee drive or any variation thereof. Here we go, find that plank. We're gonna lift one leg up, draw that knee in between the arms. Options, you can leave both feet down and just work this part. You can just hold a plank. You could just hold your down dog. Your choice. We'll switch sides next time. Ten more seconds. Three, two, one. Next up, if you're standing, this is your mummy kick before you to the other side. If you're seated, bring those weights behind the booty. We're gonna come up to a tabletop and then try to keep the butt off the mat as you swing to your L-sit. We start in three, two, mega core. Let's go. Reverse bridge, L-sit. Trying to work that contraction in the abdominals to keep that bottom off the ground. We're past the halfway mark. Again, this is your mummy kick if you're standing. Great legs. Work in the core. Flex those feet. Yes. Three, two, one. All right. This is our three-legged dog to that plank with the knee drive. Side number two, whichever side you didn't do. Let's get ready. Find that plank in three, two, one. Shift to down, leg up, and then start moving. If you're on your feet, this is your standing bird dog, opposite side from the one you've already done. Remember, it's okay. You can work plank with the knees down. Curl the toes under down dog. I am a huge, huge fan, keep moving, of deconstructing the moves to make them your own, right? Don't let your ego tell you you have to do the whole thing if that's not for you tonight. You don't want to get injured. Yep, three more seconds. Two, one, take your break. All right, squat, groiner, or squat, twisted knee if you're on your feet. Or beast squat frogger. All right, set it up. Three, two, crouch it down, counts forward. Remember, we can hop. And if you're on your feet, you're here. Ooh, low and high. Ooh, yes. Yeah, nice, Terry, nice. Nice, Suzanne, beautiful Jeannie. Oh man, these are hard, whichever one you're doing. Nice, Andy. Oh, Valerie, beautiful. Five more seconds. I know it's a lot. Three, two, one. Shake out the wrists. Friends, if you're on your feet, this is your standing bird dog, opposite elbow, opposite knee. You can do it on your side, as long as you remember next time, you have to do the other one. All right, 5 seconds. Single leg dog, or you know what I mean. Three, two, one. Here we go. Or any modification of this. Hold the plank for the next 20 seconds. With some heavy duty core. Right? Every time we modify, we're still moving forward. We're still progressing. We're getting stronger. Three, two, one, release. All right, else swing through before we hit that other side. If you're standing, this is your mummy kick. Straight legs, focusing on your midsection, not your groin. Bring those weights just behind you. Press up into that bridge. Here we go. Keep that booty up. Halfway. Woo. 10 seconds. Stay with me, whatever you're doing. You only have one more. Move and we're doing 3, 2, 1. Woo. All right, final side. 3-legged dog. 4. Your final standing bird dog. All right, last chance to shake the wrist. We have 3, 2, here we go, 1.
Oh, baby, baby, how was I
supposed to know? We're so close.
There's something wasn't right here. Oh, baby, baby, I shouldn't have let you go. Yeah,
15 seconds. Finish strong. Don't quit. Modify. Hold that plank. Even if it's not the furniture. If you have to bring it up to the wall, a stool. 3, 2, and 1. If you're on the mat, go ahead and enjoy a little child's pose here briefly. Notice how you're breathing. Notice how you feel. We are finished with all the hard stuff. Come on up. If you're on the mat, take your time standing. Grab your fingertips, clasp them. Roll your wrists out. And switch directions. Right. Take that right across the body. Keep pulling that shoulder back away from the ear.
Hit me, baby, one more time. My loneliness is killing me. I'm just confessed.
And release the side. And elbow up.
Boy, you got me blinded. Oh, pretty baby, there's nothing that I...
And gently release. Really quick quad stretch. Especially if you were on the ground doing the beast squats. Squeeze your cheeks. Tuck your tailbone. Make those knees point down and close to one another. And take it to a quick figure 4 here. Sit back in that chair. If you want to hold on to a wall or something, Jolene, shelf.
Jolene, Jolene, Jolene.
And let's switch sides right into the quad stretch.
With flaming locks of auburn hair, with ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring. Your voice is soft like summer rain. And I cannot escape from you, Jolene.
And gently release figure 4.
Jolene, 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 it's hard to say I walk away from you. Jolene, Jolene, Jolene.
And step those feet wide. Big breaths. Breathe to the bottom of that rib cage. Here we go. Inhale. And exhale. Hands down. One more time. Big breath. Inhale. And exhale, hands to your heart. I hope you enjoyed that workout. If this was your first time in class with me, the good news is I don't do the same interval timing every week. We change things up. So there's probably a style of intervals that I do that you like better than what we did tonight, unless you totally love tonight. and the other thing I would say is if you are on a friends and family pass here trying out for the week. Please try other trainers too. There's someone whose voice resonates for you, even if it's not mine. And I hope you find the trainer and classes you love. All right, I will see you all next time.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye, Suzanne. Bye, Janet. Bye, Christiana. Bye, Deanna. Bye, Kels, Aaron, Jeannie.